Honestly, second, I remember when I first came here, I thought this was the Bay Bridge. I was so stupid.
You thought this was the Bay Bridge when you first got here?
Well, because we were coming home from Lake Tahoe and I saw this bridge. Oh, we're to the Bay Bridge already. It looks like the Bay Bridge, it's just a lot smaller. Mister.
I do hope that someday we can meet Father Angelo again. But until that day, I'll just have to remember Father Angelo and remember him in my heart and in my mind and in my soul. And if you're watching this, Father Angelo, we love you, and we'd like to see you again. That's delicious pizza. Everybody should have pepperoni, mozzarella pizza for breakfast. These are Mount Shasta ice cubes, made from the best water on earth. I was looking for a plastic bag for my dirty underwear, and I thought that we threw one away in here. I don't see it anywhere in there.
All I see is a pizza box.
Yeah, we don't have any plastic bags. I don't. Just put it in the corner. Just put your dirty underwear in the corner.
I'll just have to tie it like it's a knot.
Yeah.
I've also got this handkerchief. It has all this like yellow stuff on it.
Huh. Weird. Okay, well.
So I wanted to put that in the bag too. So, yeah, it's a nice day today. And I just had a shower with Mount Shasta water.
How do you feel?
Oh, really refreshed.
Yeah, it's a magical water.
Oh, yeah.
There's something in it that's electrifying.
Oh, yeah.
Makes you feel good. Okay, well, I'll let you get dressed. Yeah, just put them in the corner. That's what I do. Stick them in the corner.
Wow. That's weird. So.
We'll get you what you want.
Yeah. Hopefully I'll feel better. Hopefully the water and the steam like from the sauna will kind of clear me out. Because I don't know if I'm getting cold or not. You didn't. I don't think you did call today, did you? I think what happened was the office, because this is a house, and the office was calling to tell us that the guys were going to mow the lawn or something. Right after I called you, I saw them, so the guys come. So, no, not too bad. Is it hot there? Yeah. Here it wasn't that hot. We went to the hot springs. And, yeah. Yeah, because I only have 11 minutes. You have the number, right? Right back. Okay, back. Just call me back, because otherwise I'll use up all my minutes. And then we'll go. Hello? Yeah, because I only had 11 minutes left. I was afraid I'd use them all. I got a Hungarian guy one time, but that was at Sunnybrae Park. There seems to be a lot of Europeans. You know, like one time I went to McDonald's and there were Russians working there. Yeah.
There he is.
You gonna dance for us?
Yeah, he said later. He does voices.
Really?
And he's gonna do them later on tonight.
What kind of voices?
What kind of what?
Voices.
Your voices that you do, your little character voices?
Oh, it's just different personality.
There's some strange creatures around.
I know. I'm filming one. Oh my god. Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh my god. There is something really weird here. Oh, shit. That is bizarre. This is impossible.
Watch out for the flux field.
Oh, great.
Jesus. You must be dreaming.
Yeah, just a little cottage. Just a little house on the side.
Yeah, it would be nice to put up a little house. And keep the garden, of course.
Oh, that's...
And we...
What are you eating now? What do you got here?
It's called a grilled stuffed burrito. And it has beans and rice and tomatoes and beef. And it seems similar to the seven-layer burrito, except it's not grilled. Huh. And these are not soft. And that was pretty cool, being in the hot springs.
It got your appetite going.
Yeah, actually, I didn't think I was that hungry. And I hope I can eat dinner. Maybe I won't have a steak, maybe I'll have halibut, but I had this big burrito. And if I knew the only three regrets I have about the hot tubs, number one, I should have kept my tub longer. Number two, I should have taken my sheet. And number three, I should have locked up my wallet and valuables so I wouldn't be paranoid all the time. What? Mm. let me tell you about something that happened to me a long time ago, but it does happen every so often. I had a lot of gas. I mean, not just a little gas, but I mean a lot of gas. And I walked over to my bedroom, and sometimes when I fart, it makes my pants brown. I mean, I don't know if you have that problem, but my underwear gets all brown. So I pulled down my pants so it wouldn't make my pants all dirty. And I started to fart. And it just kept going and going and going. And it was so continuous. I mean, it wasn't like... It wasn't like that. I mean, that's broken up. That's three farts. I mean, this thing was like... But it was even better than that. I mean, it was longer and it was louder and it was just really, it just had a lot of power to it. So that's the story of the big fart. I would now like to present you with my character voices. Mr. Amazing director. Your films, as they say, challenge every person who views them to think very seriously about these implications that I would say that their life has to undergo.